In the name of Allah, the most gracious and the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum everyone. I hope you all are fine, safe, happy and healthy, enjoying the best of your health. Today is Wednesday, 6th May 2020. We are going to start a new topic today, that is unit number 14, page 135. Biodiversity in Pakistan. Before heading towards our lecture, I would request you to kindly open your books on page 135. Biodiversity in Pakistan. In this chapter, we'll try to learn what is biodiversity, what is ecosystem, factors that lead to the exploitation of biodiversity, names of the endangered species in Pakistan, and steps to conserve biodiversity. Biodiversity. The word bio means life and diversity means different. The variety of plants and animals in a particular area or habitat is called biodiversity. Okay, this statement means that the variety of plants and animals, different kinds of plants and animals living within the same area is called biodiversity. Biodiversity is also known as biological diversity. Another name for biodiversity is biological diversity. It refers to all the animals, plants, and microbes in a specific area, in a particular area. Now, what is an ecosystem? An ecosystem is a community of living organisms interacting with each other and with their non-living environment. The word interacting means here responding or depending. Okay, so it is a community or a group of the living organisms which are depending on each other as well as on their non-living environment. We can take the example of an animal. As we know that the animals are unable to synthesize or prepare their food directly, so they depend on the plants either directly or indirectly. Either these animals are grass eaters or they depend on those animals which eat grass. What makes up an ecosystem? All living things like plants, animals, bacteria, non-living things like the sun, rocks, the soil, wind, water, etc. Okay, factors responsible for the exploitation of biodiversity. Exploitation means harm or damage. Okay, now what are the factors that have harmed or damaged this biodiversity? Rapid human population growth means overpopulation. Due to overpopulation, lots of residential areas are required, due to which we are cutting the trees and making residential areas. Deforestation. Deforestation means the cutting of trees and the clearing away of forested areas. Overgrazing. The animals are allowed to graze in any area. None of the area is there which is confined only for the grazing. Soil erosion. The cutting away or the washing away of the soil due to heavy rainfall or floods. That is called soil erosion. And the last one in this category is pollution. Okay, so because of all these factors, what are we facing? We are facing the extinction of lots of animals. So here we are going to discuss the endangered species in Pakistan. The endangered species or the endangered animals are those which are very less in number, which are left very less in number. So the best known among them is the snow leopard. Okay, it lives in the mid elevations of the Himalayas. Elevations, height. So it means that snow leopard is adapted to cool environment, snow, where there is snowfall throughout the year. Other endangered species are the Asian elephant, hog deer, flying squirrel, Kashmir musk deer, fishing cat, and marhor, the national animal of Pakistan. It is also at the brink of extinction, brink, edge. Birds at risk of extinction in Pakistan. Extinction means a time will come when we will not be able to find them anymore. So not only the land animals, but also the birds are at this risk. Among them, the important ones are red-headed vulture and Egyptian vulture. Now, among the sea animals, we are having the Indus River dolphin. It is also one of the endangered species. And what are the causes for it being endangered? Shortage of water due to the canals and all those things. Entanglement in fishing nets. Sometimes they get caught in the fishing nets. And unsustainable fishing practices. Unlawful or unsupportable. Juniper forests of Balochistan. Not only the animals, but the trees are also at the risk of extinction. Juniper forest is the oldest juniper ecosystem in the world. This national heritage is facing threat from a parasitic disease caused by a small plant, the dwarf mistletoe. Dwarf, very small, mistletoe, a kind of creeper. Parasitic disease, a disease caused by a parasite. So because of this parasitic disease, the juniper forests are also at the brink of extinction. They are also getting lesser and lesser with the passage of time. Steps to conserve biodiversity. Now, what steps should be taken in order to conserve, to save, or to protect the biodiversity? Government has taken serious steps in order to protect the biodiversity. In this regard, many national parks have been made across Pakistan. The aim to establish or to make the national park is the reason to save these endangered plants and animals. So the important ones among the national parks in Pakistan are Lal Sohanra National Park. Lal Sohanra National Park is located in Bahawalpur, which is located in Punjab. And it has deserts, forests, and ponds. It is one of the largest national parks of South Asia. The next one in the list is Kirtar National Park. Kirtar National Park is located in Karachi and Jamshoro, which is the district of Sindh. It was founded in 1974 and is the second largest national park in Pakistan. Hunjarab National Park. Hunjarab National Park is located in Gilgit-Baltistan. It is the third largest national park in Pakistan. And it was established to protect the Marco Polo sheep, a species of sheep. called Marco Polo. Chiltan Hazarganji National Park. It covers an area of 12,567 hectares. It is located near Quetta in Balochistan, and it was established in 1978 to save the Chiltan Marhor. Margala Hills National Park. Margala Hills National Park is located in Islamabad, and it was established in 1980. Chitral Gol National Park. As the name indicates, it is located in Chitral, along the bank of River Chitral. It has a wide variety of flora and fauna. Flora and fauna both are Latin words. Flora means plants and fauna means animals. So in the end, we can say that biodiversity is responsible for the sustainability of all the creatures. It has kept us uplifted. Sustainability, it has support us. It is high time now to take some practical steps for the conservation of biodiversity. It is a high time, it is the right time to take some practical steps to save our biodiversity from damage. Otherwise, the future generation would see only pictures of the biodiversity. Now it's time for home assignment. And your home assignment is, you are going to search the internet and find all about the endangered peacocks. Also mention the reasons for their being at high risk. You're going to write the reasons as well. Why are they endangered? Well, it was all for today. I hope you would have understood the lecture. Try to take a very good care of yourself. See you soon with the next video. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.